A new vaccine for honeybees? Let's talk about it. Welcome to InsideTheHive.tv, the show that takes you into the world of bees. I'm Umberto Boncristiani. If you're new to the channel, we are all about bees here. We like to talk about this incredible insect. If you like bees, please consider to subscribe and also hit the bell button so you don't miss a single video. Researchers from University of Helsinki in Finland announced last week the first edible vaccine for honeybees. The product called Prime Bee is gonna hit the market pretty soon, and it looks like it's already preparing everything for it. They have a website, and because of that, the media got crazy about it, and there's a lot of speculations, and I decided that that might be a good thing to talk about it today. As far as I understood, the way it works is like that. The queen bee is gonna receive some kind of feeding material. This feeding material is going to trigger a specific immunity against American fowl brood, and this specific immunity is going to be transferred to the next generation of bees spreading all over the colony. In an insect world in the past, scientists believed that insects only rely on innate immune system and they didn't have any specific immune system against pathogens. But apparently this have changed in the last 10 years or so. There are plenty of evidence out there showing that insects have some kind of a specific immune system, and not only that, they're able to transfer that specific immune system to the next generation of insects. So the concept is not new. It's called transgenerational immune priming and is described in insects many years ago. But the first article that demonstrated that in honeybees come in 2014, and it's from the Dr. Javier Hernandez Lopez. But in this article of 2014, they have a proof of concept. However, they didn't show any, they didn't have any idea about the mechanisms behind that, how that specific immunity is transferred to the next generation of bees. So 1 year later, in 2015, the same group that just announced the vaccine published something very interesting. I'm gonna leave a link in the description below so you can check that out. What the researchers from Finland find out in that article is that honeybees are able to get fragments and through the meat gut put the fragments of American fowl brood in the hemocells, in the hemolymph of the honeybees, and these fragments of American fowl brood end up connected with a very important protein of honeybee called Vitellogenin in the fat bodies. And not only that, they go a little further and find the same fragments of American fowl brood into the eggs of that queen. It's probably the beginning of our understanding of how transgenerational immune priming works in honeybees. However, in that same article, they didn't show any proof of concept but showing protection, showing that those eggs that have those fragments have the potential to defend themselves better in the presence of American fowl brood. So I did a little digging and I found a patent. The claim of the patent is to protect the idea of a vaccine for insects. They try to cover all insects, not only honeybees. They show a list of possible pathogens they are working on it, and that cover a lot of different pathogens from honeybees, most of them bacteria and fungi, no mention about viruses. So I found what I was looking for. I was looking for some data showing protection, showing that the vaccine works. And the way they did the experiment was very simple. They use the vaccine they develop in two groups of queens. One group of queens, they give the vaccine, and the other group of queens, they didn't give the vaccine. And they wait for those queens to lay eggs. They graft those eggs and wait for them to hatch, collect the larvae, bring that larvae to the laboratory, and then and the specific time of their development, they challenge those larvae with a different amount of American fowl brood, with different amount of spores. And then they compare the mortality of those larvae over time. Very well designed experiment, and the results were even more interesting. The results are very straightforward. When they used the concentration of 5 spores per larvae, they were able to get a protection rate of 90% survivorship. That's a high number, that's very, very promising. However, when they increase the amount of spore, the amount of exposure to American fowl brood to 20 spores per larvae, there was only a protection rate of 50%. So there was a reduction there, meaning that if you increase the amount of spores, maybe the protection that was passed to the next generation is not that strong. So putting all of this together, I was thinking about this whole vaccine thing, and my thoughts on that are this. I'm celebrating, I'm excited because I could see advancement in the science of honeybees. There is a huge potential in this vaccine. And however, I have a little concern. The proof of concept for the vaccine that is written in this patent, in my opinion, in my experience with American fowl brood, do not make me comfortable. In real life situations, we know that American fowl brood are able to produce, for example, in one single larvae that got infected, you can get 1 billion spores there. This is a billion with capital B. It's a lot of spores. So it's not difficult to do a simple math and understand that in real life situation, bees might be exposed to a much higher concentration of spores, around thousands of spores per bee, per larvae in that case. And the vaccine were able to show protection with very small amount of spores. If we increase the amount of the spores, the protection goes down. And that's my concern here in a real life situation. I'll be thinking myself, is this vaccine gonna work in a real life situation? And I'm not comfortable to say yes. But what I can say is that because the patent was filed a while ago, around 2-3 years ago, my hope is that they have improved the capacity of this vaccine and gonna bring something to the market that really can help the beekeepers. So for the developers of the vaccines, congratulations, that's very good news. I hope you guys the best. I'm very excited to see this in the market and to test it myself. Let me know if I can do anything. I would love to collaborate. Let me know if I can put my hands in one of those. I would love to do an independent test here in the state of Florida to show to the commercial beekeepers here the results that we're gonna get. So that's it for today. I hope you guys enjoy, learn something new. Please hit the like button, that helps a lot. Please share with friends and family if you like what the things we're doing here. Consider to subscribe, and thanks for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next video, inside the hive.tv, the show about bees.